Hi YouTube, this is Michigan Snow Pony Renee, and I just want to do a little video about how I start seeds. This isn't a how to start seeds, this is a how I start seeds. And these are tomatoes and cauliflowers and I got one pepper come up so far, and some celery. But you can see, like, these cauliflower plants are really spindly, and so are my tomatoes. Oh my gosh, isn't that awful? Because all I do is put them in the window. I don't have warming mats, I don't have grow lights, I don't have a greenhouse. This is very low tech. And so they come up and they get very spindly. Now you can prevent this by having nice grow lights and a fan blowing on them. But what I do is I just transplant them. Now when you transplant tomatoes, you tend to do that anyway. You transplant them way up the stems, you know, take off the first couple leaves. But I end up transplanting before they even go outside at least once. And I take these little spindly things and I put them in bigger pots, deeper pots, and just right up to the leaves. And let me see if I can get a different angle here. There we go, a little bit. I don't know if that's more helpful or not. And I'll do that maybe once or twice more, depending on how soon before I can get them outside, or at least get them in my little covered greenhouse on wheels that I wheel in and out of the garage. But right now it's pretty chilly. It's late March. And I have to start my seeds indoors pretty early because I'm in Michigan. And with our cooler summers we've been having, if I don't do this now, I won't have tomatoes. So this is what I'm left with. But it works, and if you like to go low tech and don't want to make a big investment in your seed starting equipment, this is one other way to do it. And I will show you what these look like in a week or so. Okay, it's been about, I should have kept track better. I think 4 or 5 days now since I did the transplanting. And I now have my little seedlings in my movable greenhouse sitting in my daughter's room, because hers is the only room in the house that has an accessible southern facing window. We have one in our bedroom as well, but the way our bed is positioned in there, there's no room to put this. So she gets to make room for it in her room. And I'm not going to pan around because it's a typical 12-year-old's room, and I'll just get angry if I look around too much. I'm always honored to clean her room. But anyway, I want to show you what these look like now, because they were pretty spindly and pathetic. And now I think they're looking pretty good. There's all those tomatoes. Now I will replant these at least one other time. This one even got kind of crunched right there when I was putting the plastic lids on and off, but it's going to straighten out. And when I replant these again, I'll be planting them up high, and they'll probably be replanted at least one more time before they go out in the ground. And every time, especially with the tomatoes, every time I replant them, I'm making the stalk and the root system stronger, because the tomatoes, you know, if you put dirt up to here, it sends out roots below that level and just makes for a stronger plant. So you really don't worry about this too much. Now, as it warms up, as our days get a little warmer, this will be going out into the garage, this whole greenhouse, and it's on wheels. So I will wheel it out during the daytime when it's sunny, hopefully, and then wheel it into the garage at night when it's still getting fairly cold. But tomatoes, and I've got some cauliflower. I've started celery this year. I've never tried celery. These are all little celeries, and boy, did I have to thin those out. And then my yellow sweet peppers, eggplant, and I'm waiting for green peppers. Green peppers never like me at any point, whether it's starting them, getting them to grow, getting them to set fruit. I always have trouble with green peppers, and I love them, and so I get very frustrated with peppers. But apparently the yellow peppers think I'm okay. But the other thing I have started is lots and lots of basil. This is Italian basil that's up, and I have some purple basil here. And oh, I see my sweet basil is starting to come up over here. I want to make pesto. And leave that on for now. So that's what I've got started, but But that's what I do, and it's very low tech. I don't have the heating mats or anything like that. I just do what I can, low tech, and using these little greenhouses and the covered whatever they're called, trays. And I have pretty good luck with that, but I do have to replant several times, usually, before I can get them in the ground, because our springs have been late the last few years, and our summers have been cool, and if I want anything to make it to maturity, like tomatoes, I have to start early. And hopefully my husband will get the front beds hooped over, because I want to grow my tomatoes and my non-existent peppers in there. Because I think I'm going to need a greenhouse situation with as how cool our summers have been. So there you go. And if you don't want to do the heating mats and the grow lights and all that, if you have a southern window and some of these little starter trays, I use the same ones year after year. They get pretty icky, like this one. I don't know if you can see how worn that is, but they still work. And, you know, you can do your own starts. Very low tech.